It is Thursday, and I just came back from the Lidl. And yesterday I was at the Aldi, and I have a few products from the Aldi as well in the back there. But most of this haul is from the Lidl as usual. And I went on my bicycle again. Yeah, I timed myself. It is, from where I live, 12 minutes on the bicycle, a one-way trip. Which is really, really, you know, quickly. Quick little trip to do on a bicycle. At least here in the Netherlands, it's all nice bicycle paths and stuff. So anyway, I'm going to keep going on the bicycle. Although I did have a little bit of rain on the way home. That's, you know, we're in the Netherlands. We have rain here, lots of rain. But, you know, a little bit of rain is no problem. I did manage to fit everything in my saddlebags except the loaf of bread over there and that bucket. I'll show you what's in there. That went in a bag, you know, hanging from the handlebars. Everything else was in the saddlebag. So as long as I have a haul that is about this big, I can do it on a bicycle. Once I need to buy a big bag of dog food, you know, we're going to have to take the car. Anyway, let's see what we got. We got some really good deals here. These are some stir-fry vegetables, two different kinds. I had a coupon for these with Lidl Plus app. With their app, you get coupons. And I think they were like 25% off, yeah. Plus, this was marked down. And I wasn't sure if you could still get your coupon discount on a marked down item. Turns out you can. So the original price for this stir-fry vegetables, this is Chinese cabbage, pak choi, sugar snaps, red onion, and bean sprouts. The original price is, let me check, it was $1.99, and I paid $1.07 for that with the markdown and the coupon from the Lidl Plus app. And this was originally $1.69, and this is mushrooms, leeks, red onions, and parsley, and this was now $1.27. So that's a really good price. I'm making curry wraps. I bought tortilla wraps last week. I still have chicken fillet in the freezer, and I have that jar of curry sauce in the cupboard. You know, it's been there a while. So we're making curry wraps, which I really like. Because, you know, I had rice this week. I had rice last week. Usually I eat curry with with rice, or usually, you know, half the time. But I also like to make these curry wraps. They're really good. So that's why I have these stir-fry vegetables. This I found in their extreme markdown section. This is the waste me not section, where everything is 25 cents, and this is just some seasoned potatoes. I'm gonna stick these in the freezer, and then next week I will have these. I have some meat as well that can go with it, and then next week we'll see whatever vegetables they have on sale, you know, we'll buy. So this is basically for next week, but for 25 cents, you know, I'm taking it and I'm stuffing it in the freezer. The spring onions were on sale. Let me check how much they were, because oh, 39 cents for the little bunch. And I'm going to add these to the curry, basically. You know, I wouldn't have bought them if they weren't on sale, because there's already onions in here and I have onions in the fridge still. But, you know, for 39 cents, we'll throw in some spring onions. They're delicious. And then I bought a couple of treats, you know. These are so good. And they were on sale now. They're already marking down all their Easter stuff, because they used to be $1.99, this little bag of chocolate eggs. But now they are $1.49. Everything was marked down of their Easter stuff. So I got this little, and this is a milk chocolate with a strawberry filling, and then a dark chocolate with a orange filling, which was nice. This is the meat I mentioned. These are fresh wiener schnitzel. You can't really, there's two in there. I don't know if you could, they moved around on the bicycle a little bit. But there's two nice size wiener schnitzels in here. And these were on sale this week, just a regular sale price, if I can find it. Oh, they were $2.99, and I think they're usually $3.99, so it was a nice sale. And I really like schnitzels, and these are delicious. I will have these, like I said, with the potatoes that I got for 25 cents. And then next week we'll see whatever vegetable is on sale. This goes in the freezer as well for next week. And then they had French weeks. You will see, I have some French items. They had French weeks. And I've had these before. These are crepes. with or crepes, as you call them in English, but we call them crepes, with chocolate filling. And, you know, they're just very thin pancakes with a chocolate filling. And they're really delicious. And I've had these before and I saw them and I thought, oh, as a dessert, $1.59, you know, it won't break the bank for a dessert item. The same with the Madeleines. I didn't get my Kit Kats because I got my Madeleines instead. Plus, you know, I had the chocolate eggs. These will be my treats for the week, pretty much. They're just, you know, a cake, little cakes, and they're so good. And they have these whenever they have the French weeks, and then usually I pick up a bag of these little cakes. $1.99 for the bag. And then pita breads, because I was out, and, you know, I need pita breads for my shawarma. And I did notice something at the Aldi, because I actually checked out the price of the pita breads, because I needed pita breads this week. I knew that. And since I was at the Aldi yesterday, I checked out the pita breads there, and they were 99 cents for the same amount, you know, the same size package, basically. And I knew that at the Lidl, they're cheaper, and they are cheaper. They're 69 cents at the Lidl. So I figured, not everything, you know, is equally priced between Aldi and the Lidl. That is significantly more expensive. And it's the same. I've noticed this with a few items now. I've noticed this with the toilet paper. We'll get there. I noticed it with the applesauce that I always have. You know, that was significantly more expensive. And now with the pita bread. So the way it's looking right now, but of course, I've only done a few, you know, a little shops at the Aldi. The Aldi is more expensive than the Lidl, with sort of your regular, you know, of the run-of-the-mill items. So that was interesting. Anyway, 69 cents for the pita breads, because I was out. And then bread, my favorite bread. This is your fine whole grain bread, basically. Just a very nice bread. They had it on sale because Consumentenbond, it's like a consumer report organization that we have here in the Netherlands. They test out products. And they had tested out, like, you know, your very simple whole grain breads. And Lidl's bread came out, like, best. And so to celebrate, Lidl put it on sale. So instead of paying 99 cents, what I usually pay for my bread, it was 69 cents. So that was nice. And yeah, I might have picked up two loaves, you know, for that price. But honestly, I don't have room in my freezer for that. I have emptied out the freezer a little bit, but it's still, you know, pretty. And a loaf of bread does take up quite a bit of space. So, you know, it's fine. It was nice to have it on. I would have bought it anyway because I needed bread, but it's nice to have it on sale. And then, of course, eggs. I need my eggs every morning. I have some eggs and they're $1.95 like usual. 12, that's free range eggs. And then let's do the, oh, look at that. Shawarma was on sale this week. So my freezer is going to be chock full of shawarma. Well, not chock full, but this is eight portions. Eight portions. Yeah, that would be nice. No, it's four portions. One, you know, container is two portions. And I have two containers. And I have, that is why I say eight. I have four portions still left in the freezer now. Am I saying that? No, I have three. No. I ate one last week, so I have three portions. So I have a total of seven portions of shawarma now. So that will last me a good month and a half. So yeah, I don't have to worry about it. But the shawarma was on sale, just a regular sale. But, you know, we welcome that. We wait for that. I only buy my shawarma when it is on sale or marked down. But now I have enough. It was $2.49 per package. So that is a really good price. Anyway, and then we have dog food, like usual. Two cans, 95 cents each for the puppies. And we have a little lunch item for now. There's two in here. This is a Flammekuchen, which is literally translated flame cake. It's a very thin flatbread with some sour cream, bacon, and onion. And there's two in here. And this will be a lunch for me. It looks, I've had these before and they're really nice. They're really good. But I figure, you know, as a little treat for lunch, for the weekend. I usually buy myself something special for lunch in the weekends. And then during the week, I have soup. Homemade soup. Anyway, and here is another treat that I bought myself. They had flower bulbs and all sorts, you know, flower bulbs at the Lidl this week. And they had dahlias. I love dahlias as a flower. I've never grown them, but I love them. I've always wanted to grow them. They had loose, you know, because they come in these dried roots, basically, that you plant. They had packages of the dried roots, but there were like 8 of them in there. Do you know how big a dahlia gets? Because I know how big it gets. It's like 3 feet or 4 feet, you know, a meter high, pretty much. I think this is a dwarf variety, but a regular dahlia gets really big. I do not have space on my balcony for 8 dahlias, you know, especially because I've bought all the other flower seeds and stuff. So, but then I spotted at the bottom of the shelf, they had these buckets, and they were, you know, more expensive than buying loose dahlia bulbs. But I figured this is a nice little thing to plant just to see if it will grow on my balcony. I don't know if it will. I don't know if I have enough light, you know, if it's temperature-wise. I've never grown dahlias. I've always wanted to grow them, but I never have. And I figured this is my chance. I am going to buy this. It was $4.49, I think. Let me check real quick. Yeah, $4.49 for the whole thing with the little bucket. And there's dirt in here. And then there's, you know, the root bulb. I have no clue how to plant. I think there's instructions on here somewhere. Otherwise, I'll look it up. But it's a beautiful, look at a beautiful flower. A nice bright red flower. And we are going to try to grow this on my balcony this year. It'll be a fun little experiment. Like I said, I never grown dahlias, always wanted to. So this will be a fun little thing to do this spring. Now, this was my Lidl haul. And the total was a 27. Let me show it to you. Oh, if the receipt wants to work, which it doesn't. It's going all sorts of crazy ways. Here's the receipt. It was a 27.71. And you know, that's including almost 5 euros for the... and another almost 5 euros for the shawarma and, you know, vegetable stuff. It's a pretty standard haul for me. Anyway, I did stop at the Aldi, like I said yesterday, because I needed to get my car washed because we've had, you know, snowy weather here a couple of weeks ago, and we salt our roads, and so the salt gets on your car, and you need to wash your car. Now, last week, it was still super busy at the car washes everywhere. It was on the news and everything, so I thought, I'll wait a week. I don't feel like standing in line to have my car washed anyway. But the local car wash here yesterday, there was nobody there. So I was able to get the car all clean. And that is pretty much on the way to the Aldi. And I needed toilet paper. And last week they had toilet paper on sale at the Lidl, but I missed out. It was all sold out by the time I got there. They had it on sale starting Monday. Yeah, by the time I got there on Thursday, it was already sold out. That happens sometimes. But I saw, because I do get like the email from Aldi every week with their sales items, I saw that they had toilet paper on sale. And I figured, let's go get it. And they also had this huge thing of toilet paper. Was $4.99. I don't have the receipt anymore. So this is just from the top of my head. $4.99 for the toilet paper. And then they had this name brand fabric softener. That is one. I buy store brand everything, right? I love store brand items usually. I got no problem buying store brand. It saves you a lot of money. But there are a few items where I really like to indulge in name brand items. And fabric softener is one of them. I just have a thing with perfumes and scents. And I always also have, you know, expensive, well, name brand perfumes. It's another one of those items that I like to splurge on. But the same with fabric softener. And I do look out for, I never pay full price for these because they are ridiculous. These full price are like 350, 4 euros. So we're not paying that for the name brand item. But I can usually find them on sale somewhere, or they have them at Lidl, or they have them, well, not at the Aldi, or they have them at the Action also, you know. And usually you pay around, you know, between 2 and 3 euros for a sort of sale price. And I'm happy to pay that occasionally. Anyway, they had these at the Aldi. They were $2.99, which is, yeah, exactly the price I like to pay. And I picked up two because I was pretty much all out of my name brand fabric softener. I have a few store brand items still, because when I wash my the bedding for my dogs and the pillows and stuff, I use the store brand items. They don't get name brand fabric softener, you know, and it's too expensive. But for my clothes and my bedding, my, you know, sheets, I do use the name brand. So that's why I only had store brand left. But now I have name brand, thanks to Aldi. Thank you, Aldi. I also picked up this butter. This is a light butter that is for a sandwich. We put butter on our sandwiches. I occasionally do that, but they had this, they don't have this at the Lidl. So that's an interesting difference. If they did have this, this is basically a light butter for your sandwich that they had at the Aldi. I do not remember what this cost. I think it was like 150 maybe, 195 maybe. I honestly don't remember. Under 2 euros. So you're just going to have to live with that mystery because I already threw away the receipt. So those are the items I picked up at the Aldi yesterday. And the rest, of course, today from the Lidl. Now, I'm going to stick this in my oven and have lunch because, oh, this is going to be so good. And we'll see you next week for another haul. Thank you for watching. I really appreciate it. Do subscribe so you won't miss anything. And that way you won't miss next week when we will have another Lidl haul. And maybe even, you know, a little Aldi haul as well, depending if they have anything interesting on sale. Thanks again for watching. We'll see you soon. Goodbye.